Hi, I'm Ryan with Nelson Northwest, and in this video we're going to demonstrate how to adjust the set points of a Gemco 2006 rotary limit switch. Gemco rotary limit switches are commonly found on cranes, hoists, and other machinery where motion is expressed by shaft rotation. There are two types available. There's a 2-circuit and a 4-circuit. The 2-circuit will have 2 cams that can be independently adjusted. The 4-circuit will have 4 cams. In this demonstration, we're going to adjust a 2-circuit as if we were setting the endpoints of travel. To do this, I will need 2 tools, a flathead screwdriver and a 1/16th hex key. The hex key is normally provided with the 2006 limit switch, but it may have been removed. First, remove the cover screws. Now we can remove the cover. If the hex key is in the holder, remove it. If it's missing, you can use a 1/16th hex key. Next, move the machinery so that the shaft is rotated to the desired set point. This could be the fully open position of a door or the top of travel for a crane. I'll simulate this by rotating the shaft. Note the direction of rotation of the cam as it approaches the desired set point. Identify which snap switch you want to adjust for the set point. In this case, we'll adjust the one on the left. Loosen the set screw for the appropriate cam. The set screws are color-coded. There's a diagram with color codes in the cover. Identify the adjustment screw for the cam. Next, move the cam backwards slightly so that the switch is not actuated. If you're adjusting the end of travel, you'll move the cam back toward the middle of travel. Now, move the cam toward the set point until the switch is actuated. You should hear the snap switch click. Now tighten the set screw. Verify that the set point is now correct, and adjust if necessary. Repeat this for any other set points. Remember to put the hex key back in place and reassemble the cover. For reference, here's a diagram of color codes for set screws. If you have questions about adjusting your rotary limit switch or need replacement parts, please contact us.